Suppose your salary in 2013 is $55,000. If the annual inflation rate is 2%, what salary do you need to make in 2019 in order for it to keep up with inflation? All right, so looking at this problem, I'm going to work through it with a few steps, and then we'll see the pattern, and then I'll go back and use the compound interest formula. So the starting point is year 2013, and I'll call that year zero or year sub-zero, and that is $55,000. So for the next year, year 2014, the first year after 2013, I'll call that year one, it's going to be the previous year's salary plus 2% of that salary. So simplifying, I have $155,000 here plus 0.02 more. So you can think of that as combining like terms. I get 1.02 times 55,000. So for the next year, year 2015, I'll call that year two, it's going to be the previous year's salary, which is year one, plus 0.02 of that salary. Okay, again, treating these as like terms, I'll get 1.02 times year one, and I can substitute in what year one is right here. So I'll get 1.02 times 1.02 times 55,000. Okay, again, this part here is year one salary. Okay, so recognizing the fact that I have repeated multiplication of the same factor, I can rewrite that as 1.02 squared times 55,000. Okay, moving on to the next year, that would be year 2016. I'll call that year three. Okay, that's year two plus 0.02 times year two. And then again, combining like terms, I get 1.02 times year two. But I know that year two is equal to 1.02 squared times 55,000. So plugging in for year two, I get 1.02 times 1.02 squared times 55,000. Again, I can combine by using the rule of exponents. The bases are the same. I add the exponents. I get 1.02 cubed times 55,000. Now at this point, you might be seeing the pattern here. Okay, so the year that I'm at matches the exponent. The base is always going to be 1.02, and I'm multiplying that by the starting amount. So I know in 2017, that would be year four. Okay, so 2017, year four, that would be 1.02 to the fourth power times 55,000. Okay, year five, which would be 2018, will be 1.02 to the fifth power times 55,000. And then again, using the same reasoning, for year six, which is where we want to end, that would be year 2019, that's going to be 1.02 to the sixth power times 55,000. Okay, so multiplying that all out and rounding to the nearest cent, you should get, excuse me, $61,938.93. Now again, you can think of this as a compound interest type of situation. Okay, the compound interest formula. Future value for compound interest is A is equal to, I just spaced on the formula, my apologies. The principal amount times 1 plus R over N raised to the N times T power, okay? Now, where P is the starting amount, the principal, R is the rate in decimal, N is the number of times you compound per year, and T is the time in years. Okay, so essentially in this formula, we are compounding one time per year. Okay, it's an annual. If you were to get a raise that matches inflation, that would be an annual raise. So we would be compounding one time a year. And we have a 6-year time span from 2013 to 2019. So T will be 6 in this formula. So plugging in, I get 55,000 times 1 plus 0.02 over 1 raised to the 1 times 6 power. Okay, now we can clean this up a little bit. It's 55,000 times, I don't want to run out of room, times, now this is just 0.02. Okay, 0.02 over 1 is just 0.02. And 1 plus 0.02 is 1.02 raised to the 6th power. Now you'll see that this is the same thing I got using my reasoning, okay, in that reiterative process I used above. Okay, so either way is fine. This way works reasonably well if you only have a few amount of years. Okay, but the compound interest formula is a lot quicker in this case.